Taste this!
Wow.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about.
So what do you know about dim sum?
Hi, welcome to Taste This TV. I'm Chef Joe Ciminera.
Remember, there are no rules in cooking.
Taste some food and have a great time on Taste This.
I bet you I can eat this whole thing.
Here you have it, my version of the duck.
Thanks for having me here today.
Thanks for having me on the show.
Grab a fresh lobster, cook it, and this is a lobster roll. But one of my favorite events, the Big Apple Barbecue.
I'm Chef Joseph Ciminera. Remember, there are no rules in cooking. Taste this.
All right, so today we're going to get started on two recipes. One is our pasta seafood dish. Next is our scallops. I love scallops, and when you see this recipe, you're going to love it. Let's talk about the products that we're going to be using today. And we have Garofalo pasta, the real deal pasta. One thing I love about Garofalo pasta that I'll always tell you is the rough edges to help this pasta sauce stick to the pasta itself. Here is our spaghetti and seafood dish in a red sauce with a little bit of a twist on it. So let's get started talking about what we have here. Obviously, we have some boiling water. We're going to take a little bit of salt. So let's get started on cooking. So we got two plates here, two casseroles. We're going to use this one for the seafood. We'll put up the fire. We got some extra virgin olive oil going in here. Now, for this type of dish, you want to put a lot of olive oil, probably about a half a cup. And then right off the bat, a little black pepper in there. Right off the bat. Keep it honest from the beginning. Now, what we're going to do is add our garlic. Garlic goes in first. Always brown your garlic. Don't be in a situation, don't be fooled by people who can't cook by saying that you just put the garlic in there and then add the sauce. That's not how you want to do it. You want that garlic to really brown and release those flavors into the oil. Very, 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 very important. Once we've gotten that stage, now we got some crushed red pepper here that goes into the oil for just a second. Because this stuff is really good once it releases its flavor in the oil, but could be horrible and deadly to the palate if it burns, and it burns quickly. We're going to put our crushed red pepper here. Now notice how it's turning brown a little bit? And now what we're going to do is deglaze it with a little bit of verde, the sparkling Italian fun. All right, so we have our wine in there, and already you can start to, when you do this dish, you're going to smell the crushed red pepper, you're going to smell the garlic, you're going to smell the wine deglazing. The alcohol's off, the sweetness of the grapes go down. Great, now we add our seafood. We got little necks here. You could use top necks, you could use cherry stones, you could even use conchos, which are the smaller version, and I just put them right in there. Rinse them really good on the outside, get all that sand off, because there's nothing worse than biting into this dish and having like sand all in your mouth. All right, now add a little bit of salt in the very beginning. Then what you're going to do is add our scallops. These are sea scallops, very big, very flavorful. Throw your scallops in there. Now, I always said if a dish starts to smell good in the early stages, it's going to be fantastic once it releases the flavor. Now, you could throw fresh basil in here, or you could take the extra step and do the basil pesto thing, and that goes down in there. Just give it a mix. Flavorful. Takes it to the next level. And that oil really helps out. You'll notice that if you got a lot of oil in there, it'll help. Okay, now, what we have here are shrimps. These are definitely huge. They usually come about 12 to a pound, which usually means that it's U12s. It's under 12 to a pound. That's the rule when you go see your fish manger or your seafood store, whatever you want to call it. What you do basically is, with this type of recipe, you don't want any tails in there. It's not a shrimp cocktail. It's not a stuffed shrimp. So just take the complete shell off the shrimp. They're real easy to do. Kind of rip it from here, turn it around, and then the rest comes off. And these are huge. Now, you can use 10s, you can use 12s, you can use 6 really big babies like that. I don't know, I just think that it's a texture thing. What I like to do is cut it down the center. Sometimes there's that vein there that you gotta need to discard. Definitely want to clean the shrimp. You know, it's funny, too, is they sell these plastic things that peel and devein the shrimp all at once. God, if they would have came out with that in my days in a restaurant. All right, make sure you get that ugly, disgusting, nasty-looking vein stuff out of the way. And I usually use just a paper towel. I just grab it. I don't like to use my fingers or run it underwater. I don't want to run the shrimp after I cut it underwater. I just feel like it loses some of the seafood flavor. So just take the extra time to find where the vein is, which is right here, and just take it with your paper towel. Comes right out. It's like that. All right, take your shrimps, put it in here, wash your hands, clean your board. Today we're going to aipami our seafood pasta. So we're going to be using our strained tomatoes from Palmy, 100%, all natural tomatoes, no added sodium whatsoever. Pour that in there. We have strained tomatoes, we have chopped tomatoes, and we have fresh tomatoes that I just basically seeded and diced that we're going to be throwing in. Gives it a little texture. You know, I want like that kind of garden texture in there. And I throw it in there. Now we're good. Now we let that baby do its thing. Clams need to open. It'll release all the wonderful juices of the clam sauce. Now some people could go and hit it with more clam sauce. If it's got a really strong seafood taste, it's going to be overly salty. And it's not really going to balance out the rest of the things in the dish. You just keep it cool. No need to add any clam stock. Because once these babies open up like this, see, look at that. That's what I'm talking about. All that juice just goes back into the pan. And don't worry about if it looks thick after you add the tomato sauce. Because once those clams open up, there you go. Just going to add more water to the dish. Now we're going to cook our pasta. We got spaghetti here today we're going to use. Spaghetti's good with this dish. Angel hair could be better. But the general consensus today is use the spaghetti. All right. Now take your spoon and just marry everything together now. You can see these clams are opening up. Everything looks good. We got a little while. This doesn't take long. I mean, this is not the longest thing that it takes to cook here, these scallops, and you can cut them in half. I really don't want to go that route today, though. What we're going to do is now plate our pasta dish. We're going to get one of these big mambo jumbo bowls, right? And what we're going to do is throw our pasta. This is how I like to do it. Now, take some of your sauce first. Nice tomato sauce. See that? It's really beautiful looking. Don't worry about too much of the seafood there. What you do is you just take your tongs, or whatever you want to use. You could use a fork if you want. That's cool. And that's it. And I just kind of let it breathe for a minute. What it does is it soaks up this wonderful flavor, and it really takes it to the next level. And that's exactly what you want. What you want is the pasta to take on the flavor of that tomato sauce. Don't let it go away yet. Olive oil. Gets olive oil twice. Just like it soaks up the red sauce, it'll soak up the olive oil. Now, you can prepare your dish. Take your clams, put your clams around the side. Woo! Looks good, smells good. Remember what I talked to you about, that crushed red pepper? I think you're going to like that technique there, folks. Take a little bit of your shrimps, scallops. Now, what we're going to do with this, of course, is you want to drizzle a little olive oil. Now, I have these really delicious micro basil ferns. Doesn't look like basil, but it's got a really, really good flavor. Now, what you do with the basil, in order to really get the flavor out of basil and for fresh herbs, you got to kind of get the oils out, you know? So crush it with your finger and then put it over the top. You can do that with a knife, too, but... And there you have it. There's our pasta dish. Right? Now this is what I'm talking about, a seafood pasta dish. Alright? I hope you enjoyed it, and thank you so much for watching me on this fun-filled episode of Taste This TV. I'm your host, Chef Joe Ciminera. Remember, there are no rules in cooking. Taste this.